Hello and welcome to the latest edition of All About the Disco. I am your host, as always, Billy, and I've got snazzy graphics in the background now. I know things are heating up here. Episode 3 of All About the Disco, second on YouTube. Hope you're doing well. What we've got coming up for you this weekend, my word, it's the Disco Derby. I can't wait to get into this show and speak about it with you, give you a preview of what's going to happen or what's lined up. Because there's two VIP matches, three championship matches, and then to top it all off, we've got the Disco Derby itself. A over-the-top rope slash hybrid singles match towards the end for the final two. The winner will get a championship opportunity of their choosing. And, you know, that's amazing. It's going to be amazing. It's going to be a great night in Edinburgh at the Pleasant Sports Complex on Saturday, July 1st. To give you a bit more information, if you still haven't got tickets, I don't know why you haven't got tickets. If you can't, if you're in Edinburgh or the Edinburgh area, you should have a ticket for this show. I don't, so I don't know why I'm saying that. I'm up in the northeast here, but I can't go to the show. I've got other wise engagements, but that doesn't mean I'm not going to tell you why you should be there. You should be there at 12:30 if you've got a VIP ticket, or 1 p.m. if you've got a general. You can go to shop.discoverywrestling.com. And go get yourself a ticket for this event because it is packed. And I'm going to tell you the full card on the show. Coming up, I said two VIP matches, three championship matches, and the Disco Derby. This is one of the most packed Discovery Wrestling shows you will ever see. If this is your first time going to a Discovery show, the Disco Derby is always going to be the best one to go to. You get to see all the titles, you get to see all the big names, and you get to see a Disco Derby as well. And I'm going to keep saying it to the cows go home. I love a Rumble. I love Derby. But I love this kind of match. You get to see so many wrestlers that you may have never seen before, or you may have never got the chance to see if you've been a lifelong fan of wrestling or a new fan of wrestling. You're going to see a lot of faces that you may have never seen before. And that's the beauty of these kind of matches, because you get to see these faces and you get to find out more about them. If you see the likes of, and I'm going through the full Disco Derby lineup as of recording, if you get to see a guy like Will Cruz, who doesn't come up to the UK, who doesn't come up to Scotland very often, I should say. He doesn't come up to Scotland often, he does maybe just disco, he maybe does ICW, that's about it. But if you see Will Cruz on the show and you go, oh, I want to see a bit more of him, you can go down south and see TNT or whatever other promotions he's appearing at. You get to see him on the shows because you went to the Disco Derby. That's the opportunities for you and for these wrestlers to win the match and get a championship opportunity in the future. Like I said, I told you how to get tickets. I told you where it's going to be at the Pleasant Sports Complex in Edinburgh. Let's just get into the show. I think it's probably the best way to do it. Let's just go for it.
I don't believe you let Joe Henry beat you. How are you not leaving here with that Impact title?
Mate, how are you not in the Disco Derby? You're not in the Disco Derby this year.
I tell you, because of you! You!
Us?
Yes, you! Huh? I should be in that disco. I've all been in every single Disco Derby, and I'm not in this year because of you! I should have that match, one of it was of you two meddling. Well, especially you, you pirate person.
The whole language.
Disco Derby. Since I've not got anything to do, tag match. Me and my partner.
9-9 versus
Sea Bears.
Good.
I'm not here for Disco Derby. I'm back in Japan. I go next week.
What?
I go to Japan next week.
Did somebody say tag match?
Please put me in your suitcase. Mark, I'll come over. You can teach me all about etiquette and all that, and like, you know, put a word in for me. Come on, get
mate,
it to
you'll
me.
Be fine.
Get me to Japan.
You'll be fine.
Please get me to Japan.
You'll be fine, man.
Jack, please.
Bye, Jack.
I think I'll just take them on the handicap, thanks.
Well, that was rude.
First up, we're going to check out the VIP ticket holder match. The Double D's, Dicky Divers and Debbie Dahmer, easy for me to say, taking on the Sea Bears, Rob Mills and Jarek Novak. You just heard how this all came about. It came about by at Livingston, just past the end of June. There we go. Yeah, but keep us all in. At the end of June, in Livingston for Disco's debut, there was a qualifier match for the Disco Derby match itself for entering into the Rumble, involving Rob Stowe, Dickie Divers, Rob Mills, and Jarek Novak. Rob Stowe ended up winning, and he's now in the Disco Derby. We'll probably talk about him a little bit later on. And it led to this match. Jack Morris of the 99 with Dickie Divers, he lost his match with Joe Hendry for the Impact Wrestling Digital Media Championship in that historic Pro Wrestling Noah versus Impact Wrestling match. And they were having a little bit of discussion afterwards. Divers blamed Mills and Novak of the Sea Bears. And here we are. It's as simple as that. Jack Morris, of course, as you mentioned, he's in Japan, so he won't be able to actually be in the match and represent the 99. So Debbie Dahmer has arrived to save the day, much to the chagrin of Dickie Divers. I'm very interested, though, when I was doing my little bit of research here, and I'm probably going to be corrected if I'm wrong, and I'm happy with that if I'm correct. I'd rather have all the information correct somewhere, whether it's a Twitter comment, tell me that I'm rubbish. But this is the first time that Sea Bears are teaming in Discovery. However, I think they've teamed a little bit longer. So they've teamed longer in Reckless Intent. I think they may have had a match at SWA. That's a pure guess. I'll be perfectly honest with you. But I know they've had matches about either as a team or individually in the likes of SWA and a little bit in Source, I think, as well. So they've got a bit more experience together as a team. But Dickie Divers, being the veteran of this group, this four-person matchup, he's got a bit more of a tag team background as well through like the 99, former tag team champions in ICW, with the STI as well, William Grange, again another ICW tag team champion winning duo. And as much as he doesn't like or seem to dislike the concept of the double D's with Debbie Dahmer, they have been undefeated for the last year in tag team competition, so something's working. I don't know what Divers thinks about this team actually being a very well-oiled machine and being able to actually pick up wins. Debbie Dahmer herself, she's had a great run in Disco recently. She's undefeated again the last 12 months, including singles competition. She had a recent victory over Tonga. Had a match with her at a recent Discovery Wrestling event. So she's on a run of her life right now in Discovery Wrestling. And to be honest, with the women's title match, the title match that's got coming up, if Debbie wins, that's a year of not being pinned in a match. Surely she has some sort of say. I mean, most of her matches, admittedly, have been tag team matches, so they would have some sort of say to the tag team title picture. But with Debbie having that singles victory as well in there, she could probably have some say to go in, right, if Casey, Nina Samuels, whoever wins that match, get Debbie Dahmer in there. She's more than got the championship credentials, being a former Fair City Wrestling women's champion as well. So she's got, you underestimate Debbie Dahmer. You underestimate her. She's very good at being a bit off-center when it comes to just being a bit, there's some marbles loose in there, but you can't underestimate her. When she gets going, when she's focused, she's a very dangerous individual in the ring. And if Dickie Divers can somehow embrace that and focus it, they're already a fairly unstoppable duo, but to focus that thought, to focus her championship, championship, I don't know, I'm just going to use focus again. Just focus it. Then this team could be earning tag team titles matches. This could be a team that runs Kings of the North quite close, because they'll underestimate Debbie. And Divers has got all this experience, all this tag team experience and wealth and knowledge that they make quite a duo. On the other side, of course, you mentioned Sea Bears. They're probably teaming a little bit longer. They've been a bit more of a unit for longer in Reckless Intent. Rob Mills and Jarek Novak, they haven't had too much success though. They haven't won titles. They've had some matches here and there. Rob Mills has got a bit of tag team experience over Jarek, because you have the Headbanders. So These are two teams. That's pretty much the end all of this ramble for 5 minutes. We've got two actual teams that seem to operate well as a team. Whether Divers likes it or not, Divers and Dabber operate well as a team. And this makes it very interesting for this ticket holder match. Like I said, these are bonus ones for people that pay a little extra pennies. They get a better seat. They get front, second row, whatever. And they get to see this. But I think this is going to be a good one. This is only, I mean, I'm not going to turn around and say, well, these matches are going to be rubbish. But I think this is going to be quite underrated for those that just want a bit of entertainment, a little bit of fun. I think this is going to be the match for you if you've got the VIP ticket holder experience, the extra ticket. So, yeah, this is going to be a fun one. Let's have a look at the next ticket holder match. But, yeah, keep an eye out on this match. This is going to be a fun one. I said that twice. So, must be true. Next up is a match I'm very excited to speak about that's taking place at the Disco Derby on July 1st. It's the other VIP ticket holder match. One that when it was announced, a lot of buzz came from it because of the individuals involved and because of the much hype I've given these two guys for a while now, at least a year for one, longer for the other. It's Ronan King taking on Conor Malloy. These are two guys that primarily trained up in the Northeast, up in my neck of the woods, up in Aberdeen for WrestleZone. They've done a bit of training in the likes of Joe Henry's Edinburgh Wrestling School. And they've picked up pieces of information and training all over the country. And Ronan has wrestled down in Wrestle Carnival. And these guys are possibly your future of wrestling right now in Scotland. Ronan and Conor, they're both 19, I think Conor may still be 19, maybe 29. And these guys they understand what wrestling is as a entertainment concept, and they seem to be able to provide the entertainment for everyone. So Ronan, cocky character. This is the second time he's making an in-ring appearance in Discovery Wrestling. He made his debut in Livingston, unfortunately lost to Judas Gray, so missed out on the Disco Derby because it was a qualifier. But the guy, he's 19, he exudes this confidence, he's disgustingly talented, he's a really good wrestler, he knows how to bring in a crowd, he knows how to interact with the crowd. Sometimes he's a little bit too eager with the crowd interaction, and he can get himself into a little bit of trouble and bother when he opens his mouth like his belly rumbles. But there's no denying, he understands the concept of how to be an entertaining all-round wrestler in Scotland. And at 19 years old, ridiculous. He shouldn't know how to do that. Conor Malloy is a guy that I saw right near the start of his career. He wrestled Zone and he was this plucky underdog, skinny, didn't really have much on him, getting battered by Crusher Crabe a lot, and it was the plucky underdog. That was pretty much his thing. And since then, he's evolved into this, just again, another brilliant performer. He's used things like the pandemic to get himself in phenomenal shape. He's got this confidence now, whether it's because more people are accepted of him, or he's more confident that the people just want to see him be a wrestler, and he's not hiding under his skin or anything like that. He's entertaining. He loves involving the crowd again. He loves being entertaining. I've said that so many times. So I knew this bit was going to be a ramble when I started, when I hit play or when this match was announced anyway, because I knew I'd be doing this All About the Disco episode. He's just fantastic. He's got this aerial offense. He can do a little bit of wrestling, if you want to call it quote unquote classic style wrestling. He can entice the crowd into. He can be charismatic. And these two guys, I feel like they're two sides of the same coin. Because you've got Conor on one side, who is this fantastic wrestler, who gets the crowd on his side, is really happy to be there. He slaps hands, he's all that kind of stuff. On the other side, you've got Ronan King, who I absolutely have no doubt in mind he could do that, but because he has chosen the path he's on, he's this cocky, arrogant individual who could do all the moves, he could do the wrestling, he could do the flips, he could do the 450 land on his feet on the floor, he could do all that cool stuff, and he's not doing it for crowd adoration, or he already expects the adoration, so he's not trying to get them to cheer him. If they are impressed, they should be impressed. Should be impressed because he can do that, because he's 19 years old and he's going to be a tremendous wrestler. Whether he is now or in the future, that's up for debate, I suppose, online. But in my opinion, he's probably one of the best in the country right now, especially due to his age. But as an entertainer and as a wrestler, he is phenomenal. And these two are that. And this match, I think, is a match you're going to see a lot more down the line. As these two grow, the matches are going to get more intense and better, and there's going to be subtleties, there's going to be more story behind it. And we speak about all that, and they know each other so well, so it's going to make it even more interesting as a match. What is interesting, though, there's a place like the Community Pro, they've teamed as the Aberdeen Dream Team, so not only do they know each other very well as opponents, but they know each other very well as teammates. Even though it was brief, I think it was the only team the once, but there's so much going on in this match for someone who is an absolute nerd for Scottish wrestling that I am. That I'm so fascinated by this match, and there was so much going on Twitter and the discourse about it being a match that people should be looking out for, and you should be. This is a match that if it wasn't the Disco Derby, this should have been the main show. Should have been on the main show, because of course, Disco Derby will take up the second half, main, you know, and all that kind of stuff. So you got to pace it. You got to make sure that everyone, the championship matches are on the main card. That just makes sense. But I think if it was any other show, this match would have been on the main card. I don't think that's a debate, really. I don't think it should be a debate. So with all that being said, I don't know how long I was speaking for about this particular match. I can't wait. I can't wait to know what happens, and I've got a couple friends that are at the show. I can't wait to find out what it was like, and they can tell me and regale the tales of Ronan King versus Conor Malloy 101 in Discovery Wrestling Part 1, Chapter 1, because this is a match you're going to see more often, with titles online, with higher stakes, with all that involved, and this is just the opening chapter in their Discovery Wrestling career together. I think I've said enough about that. Yeah, let's get on to the main card. Kicking off the main show, we're going to take a look at the Discovery Wrestling Women's Championship match. That's Casey defending against Nina Samuels. So we made a little bit of mention before during the first ticket holder match about this kind of match, about Debbie Dahmer hopefully, or possibly I should say, trying to muscle herself into this division. It's a very interesting match. You know, and I think this is possibly going to be one of the more underrated. Because when you look at all the matches on the show, there's some big names, some big things happening. And of course, we've got the Derby as well. It goes out, should go without saying. I've said it anyway. So we look at this. Nina Samuels has made two appearances in Discovery Wrestling, according to my research. Mainly, I looked at Cage Match. Of those two matches, she lost a Discovery Wrestling Women's Championship match against Emerson Jade. And in our second match, it was December 2019, the Disco Derby, not Disco Derby, the Christmas Disco, and she defeated Casey. She wasn't the champion at the time, so Casey. Which leaves her 1-1. But with that being said, her last victory in Discovery Wrestling was over the current Discovery Wrestling Women's Champion. So, of those two matches, she's lost against the champion, but beat the person who became the champion. So, what, in some sort of roundabout way, does that make her uncrowned champion? I don't know. That's for you to argue about. So, the match itself, Casey's coming back from a broken wrist injury, which has kept her out of action for, I think, May into June. And this is probably one of her first matches since that comeback, and possibly come matches elsewhere. And she's her second defense since winning the title in November 2021. So her title reign's been a little bit odd. She hasn't had that many defenses. She's used Moxie Malone as a substitute. She's been a little bit into the tag team tournament with Molly Spartan as the She-Wolves. So her title reign hasn't been lighting things on fire, particularly in Discovery Wrestling. But that's not to say she's not a good wrestler. It's just a case of that's just how the chips have been laid. She's been unlucky with injuries. She's been unlucky with the positions that she's been in that's meant she's had to miss shows or something like that. Because of injuries, and because she's probably one of the busiest wrestlers in the country. Between trips to like Eve down London and Iron Girders and ICW and all that kind of stuff. So not to say she hasn't put any focus on Discovery Wrestling or as being the women's champion, it's just that's how it's happened. So she's coming in against Nina Sands, former NXT UK wrestler. She's wrestled all over the country, in Europe and probably in the US as well. So she's a well-traveled wrestler, a veteran, so to speak. She's coming in to face Casey. So, like I said, I think this match is going to be quite underrated. You're going to go into this thinking, all right, okay, this isn't the big hype, but I think it's going to be a really good match. So, these two like working some hybrid styles, like a little bit of wrestling, like a little bit of brawling, like a little bit of high flying in the case of Nina Samuel. She likes a little bit of taking to the air. And Casey likes to get down and dirty, likes to turn matches into a brawl, or maybe just try and grab a limb and twist it. So I think this is gonna be good. Like I say, I'm not gonna say any match is gonna be bad, but when I'm trying to break it down in my head here, I'm trying to think, right, okay, is this a match I'd be excited for? And I'm perfectly honest, probably this is maybe what I'd be like, this is what I have to see when it comes back. But the more I talk about it, the more I think about the concept of how we got here, but Nina Samuels having that 1-1 record, but that one win being over Casey, means that Casey's possibly going to be underdog, but she'll have the championship advantage, and Molly Spartan will be somewhere, I'm sure, or Moxie Malone will be somewhere, I'm sure, as part of She Will. So there's a lot more to this match than possibly people will give credit for. And with that being said, I think it's going to be one that people will go back to and go, you know what, I may have had some level of expectation, and this is blew out the water. This is going to be one that people will be speaking about this match once it's all over, once the show ends, and go, you know what, I love the Derby because I love Rumbles. I loved Gene Money versus Big Demo. I love the tag team match. I love the VIP matches. You know what, that women's championship match. Yeah, can't wait till that's on YouTube. I can't wait to go see that again. So, yeah, keep an eye on that match. Like I say, all these matches all have the potential to be show stealers. I'll give you that as my dark horse. I would say as your match that you go, wow, yes, Casey versus Nina Samuels, amazing. Yeah, that's the one to keep an eye on. Moving on to the tag team title match now, Kings of the North, Damian Corbin and Bonesaw. They defend against the team of Kez Evans and BT Gunn. This is going to be a hard-hitting match. This is your loud chops, big slapping meat, just going all over the place, raw bodies, blood vessels bursting all over chests. This is going to be a hard-hitting affair. And that's probably what we're going to get. That's the hype. That's probably what we're going to get. Kings of the North are coming in for they've made three defenses of the tag team championships since winning them, beating Sunshine Machine, Wild Lions, if you mean to say, Wild Lions, and Deacon Matthews and Theodorus. So established teams, really. I mean, Deacon Matthews, Theodorus, the kind of team by association, but established teams they've been against. Kez Evans, the BT Gunn, they're fairly new as a unit themselves. BT Gunn has a lot of experience in tag teams with likes of Just Us, with Stevie Xavier. This guy knows tag team wrestling pretty well, you know? Kez Evans, a little bit more experienced in tag team competition, these guys have formed a little bit of a team in Reckless Intent pre-closure or pre-hiatus. So they've got a little bit of a thing as a team. BT Gunn had a hand in training Kez Evans as well. They've got a lot of history as a feud, as they've done battles all over these two. So they know each other pretty well. I'm safe to say that they've had battles all over the country. And they're now a unit. And they're a unit in ICW as well. So these guys are fairly fresh as a tag team, as a duo. But I think because they've got so much experience and so much knowledge of each other, it still makes them quite a dangerous tandem to be up against. And Kings of the North, I don't want to say they've had a fairly easy run so far, but they've been pretty dominant once they get their motor running and they get out on the highway and they're able to get some moves together and momentum going. They've been fairly formidable when it comes to all of that. They fairly destroyed Sunshine Machine towards once they started getting a bit of momentum going. Haven't seen the matches with Wild Lions and Deacon Matthews and Theodorus, but I would hazard a guess on past experience of seeing Kings of the North, that's how it's went down. They've found a weakness, they found a moment where they could jump on, and they've just went to town and demolished the competition. So, coming to this match itself, BT Gunn is probably it factor with this. He's had the championship matches in Discovery Wrestling. He's yet to taste gold in Discovery, but he's had Y Division championship matches. He's wrestled for the Ring of Honor World Championship against Cody. This guy has all the tools, and he's probably, he's a legend in Scottish wrestling right now, and will be seen as that, not only because of his in-ring work, but because of his training background and what he's producing through GPWA and Iron Girders and what he's and the students that he has prepared for wrestling in the future. And he's had tag team matches. He was part of that match with the Elite when they came to Discovery Wrestling. And one of the most, the biggest historical moment in Discovery was having Kenny Omega and the Young Bucks in as a team, as a unit, as the Elite in Discovery Wrestling. And BT Gunn was part of that match. And again, I'm going to use the word interesting so often in this preview, and it's all about the Disco podcast, because that's it. These two teams, though they have a different wealth of experience as a team, as two tandems, right? Kings of the North haven't really been challenged. They've never went into a match looking like their titles are in jeopardy. Whereas I think if they come in against BT Gunn and Kez Evans, that's the moment. If they walk in looking even the slightest bit concerned, then Kez Evans and BT Gunn have all the opportunity and the chance to win. That's the story here. If they come in confident, they come in the usual Kings of the North way, wide-eyed, angry, you know, we're just going to get a good slug of a match where possibly it will take a moment for one team to capture the win. That's what we got there. But if Kings of the North come in with any fear, then and BT Gunn and Kez Evans can grab that, can capture it, and can take advantage of it, it could be a new tag team champions at Disco Derby. That's it. That's the key here. Myself, can't wait. This is Kings of the North. I'm not a big fan of Kings of the North. They're not a team that I particularly resonate with or drift myself to as a team, but I can't deny that their championship credentials speak for themselves. Multiple-time tag team champions across the UK and Ireland. They are one of the premier tag teams in UK wrestling, UK and Irish wrestling. And this is going to be in the words of JR, this is going to be a slobber knocker for absolute certain.
2 hours later.
So, right. So what you heard there, the big speech about the tag team title match, I recorded that on Monday. And about a couple hours after editing it, putting it all together, very happy with it, that announcement came up. I actually haven't got it in front of me. It is on the screen just beforehand. It says, match update. Unfortunately, the Kings of the North will no longer be with us on Saturday, but will return to Disco soon. So, stepping up to face Kez Evans and BT Gunn are the Fair City Saints, Alex Webb, and Air Miles. So, I'm keeping the last bin because this is part of the narrative. The Fair City Saints are stepping in to face Kez Evans and BT Gunn. And this kind of changes the whole outlook and aspect of the match, because the match was going to be the dominant team versus the more crafty team, who's got the more chemistry and all that kind of stuff. So now we're got Kings of the North, Demolishers, big bruiser guys against the more agile and quick Fair City Saints, Alex Webb and Air Miles. Makes for a bit more of a contrast in styles. We'll go with that. So Fair City Saints, of course, have made appearances in Discovery before. They were in the tag title tournament, which was eventually won by the Kings of the North. And now here we are, BT Gunn and Kez Evans against the Fair City Saints. So again, as a team, as an actual unit, getting the actual matches in there, Fair City Saints have more experience in that regard as the duo. Former WrestleZone Tag Team Champions. I think they were in the Reckless Intent tag title tournament as well. And they're going up against BT Gunn and Kez Evans. I've already mentioned BT Gunn, vastly experienced in tag team competition. These two have trained together. BT Gunn's taught Kez Evans everything that Kez knows, and possibly even more. Kez Evans has got this championship experience. He was ICW World Heavyweight Champion, Zero G Champion. He wrestled Josh Alexander at Solve Pro, heavy as the head. So he's got all this championship caliber experience. He's going into this match with BT Gunn, someone who's a mentor to him, someone who's taught him, who can see what he can do, knows his strengths, weaknesses, and knows how to combat that. And with his tag team experience, that also helps. So this is going to be very interesting. A different match, absolutely different. So it's now got Gunn and Kez, two hard-hitting strikers. They like to find body parts and just punish them. And you got the high-flying Fair City Saints against them. So I think this is going to be a lot of fun. I think I said at the start of this bit that it was Kings of North versus Fair City Saints, which, you know, match I would love to see. But yeah, Gunn and Kez versus the Fair City Saints. No, it's still going to be a good match. If anything, in my personal opinion, I think it's a bit, it's even an upgrade. Even though it's not a championship match, so it'll be a downgrade to Evans and Gunn in that respect. But I think as a match itself, it's going to be really, really, really tasty. It's going to be a really great match. So, yeah, it's a change of the card. Card's always subject to change. But here I am on Tuesday morning doing the update to the podcast. So it goes out on Wednesday, hopefully with no more changes. Let's fingers crossed.
Disco Wrestling. Big Demo here with a wee message for my good friend, Gene Money. Now listen, I should have done this a couple of months ago, but Gene, congratulations, son. You did exactly what you set out to do all those years ago. You became the top dog. You became Y Division champion. Get in, son. And look at the confidence. Look how proud you are. You're throwing out challenges. You're throwing out open challenges for July 1st. And listen, I just need to tell you, you need to be careful. You never know who's listening. You never know who's going to stand up and be counted. You never know which ghost from your past is going to come back to haunt you. You see, you know, when it comes to Big Demo, you know, Big Demo doesn't like to stand on ceremony. You know, Big Demo doesn't like to let things breathe. You know, Big Demo doesn't like to wait in line. So, Gene, I need to tell you, Big Demo accepts your challenge. Okay, so Pleasant Sports Complex, July 1st, Big Demo comes back to Disco Wrestling. July 1st, Big Demo destroys Gene Money. And July 1st, Big Demo becomes Disco Wrestling Y Division Champion.
In the third of our trio of championship matches, we have the Discovery Wrestling Y Division Championship on the line. You heard Demo there. He was very quick to take up the open challenge set by Gene Money. Once Gene, one of those things where we talked about we've talked about it before, but Gene Money being like one of the lifebloods of Discovery Wrestling. He's been there since pretty much year dot. He's been there right from the start, and we've seen him evolve from this silly man to this the Mundertaker, to being a championship contender, to his knockdown matches with Andy Roberts, to his match with Big Demo, which we'll speak about in a second. He has been putting on some show stealers every show. And when you think about when he arrived, he was part of the Buffet Club. He was a bit, he was silly. He was with Uncle Bobby. They became the first inaugural Discovery Wrestling Tag Team Champions when they won the Civil War tournament. This guy has been through amazing adventure in Discovery Wrestling, and it all came to a head at the excellent adventure, segues, the excellent adventure when he became the Y Division champion. And it maybe tainted somewhat because of the way he won. It was by disqualification. There was Rob Stowe and Mr. Manaville involved, and there was a whole thing about it. But as the records will show, at the end of it all, Gene Money is the Y Division champion in Discovery Wrestling. He is adding onto a lineage that's included Chris Sabin, it's included Joe Henry, it's included Joe Coffey, Lewis Garvin. The status of that title, not everybody could wear it. It's been around for what, 8 years, eight, nine years now? And well, we've got five champions in the past that has held that belt. It just goes to show that that title means so much to so many that it's held on to with a death grip. And the way he won it, yeah, there's this asterisk point next to it. There's a little star that says, oh, by disqualification. There's people that will go, oh, but Gene didn't really beat Joe Henry, Rob Stowe, and Mr. Manaville did. So this match itself is not only a championship match. It's Gene Money versus Big Demo. I would say this match is one for Gene Money to prove that why he is the champion, why he is the Y Division champion, why he took all, why, how he earned it, how he was able to work his way up from Buffet Club, from all of that shenanigans, the Undertaker, all that kind of things, getting his soul eaten, bitten by zombies, all that stuff led him to become the champion. And this is the match where he will need to prove it. He'll need to prove why he's the champion by beating Big Demo. Demo, much like we're speaking about with Nina Samuels and Casey, the last time we saw Nina Samuels, she defeated Casey. The last time we saw Big Demo was year six in November 2021, and he beat Gene Money. And this was right about the time where we were thinking we were going to get Demo, Andy Roberts, Demo, Joe Henry, something about with the Y Division Championship, because Demo made his intentions clear following that match that he was, next time he was there, it was going to be for the Y Division Championship. He was going to be going for the title. And here he is. Took a little bit of time to get there. Of course, he's a busy man. He's wrestling in the US and Europe and what have you. But he has held up his word, and he is going to be fighting for the Y Division Championship. A guy that has been there since, what, I think the third Discovery show. They've had, what, 41, like that, 42 shows now. So he's been there at the inception of Discovery Wrestling, pretty much. So is Gene Money. And now they're fighting for the biggest prize, one of the most prestigious titles, I would say, in the country right now. And it just, there's a lot of stuff bubbling underneath. He took that big break because he went to WWE and he lost that Loser Leaves match with Dave Conrad. Went to WWE, part of Sanity, NXT. He's wrestled numerous places all over the US and Europe, and he's done that. And now he's coming back to try and capture more gold and try and capture that Y Division Championship, a title that, I mean, this guy, he's having matches with Ricochet, and having all these kind of excited big man, little man matches, and just wowing the crowds. But he's coming in here with a chip on his shoulder, chip on his big shoulder, that he's, I was having a look through these, I don't think Demo's ever had a Y Division Championship match. I could be wrong, but I don't think he has. So the fact that he's coming in, this is going to be his first opportunity at this belt. He's coming in against a guy he's beaten in the last 2 years in Gene Money. It just makes for such and I'm going to use the word again, an interesting contest. Because we're going into this going, Money, he's earned that title. He's worked his way from the silly stuff to being a viable champion, to being presented as a champion. Sure, he's still got like the nipple tape. He's still got do the dog stuff. He's doing the cool, the silly promos and all that kind of stuff. He's still got the dirty dog, the Gene Money essence. But when the bell rings now, he is held. He holds himself and he presents as an absolute top quality wrestler. So I've rambled way too much. I forgot my original point. So he's coming in. This is a different Gene Money. Sure, it's been less than 2 years since they last fought in Discovery Wrestling. Big Damo isn't coming up against the silly Gene Money who has all these shenanigans and all that kind of stuff and relies on these distractions and shenanigans. He's coming against Gene Money who has gained this confidence now that he's worked his way up. The fans have embraced him as a champion, as a Y Division champion. They supported him in that match against Joe Henry. Joe Henry, I mean, if you're coming in as a casual going into Discovery Wrestling, there's all intents and purposes, you're coming in and seeing Joe Henry, Impact Wrestling's Joe Henry, Ring of Honor's Joe Henry, WCPW's Joe Henry. You probably go, if you're casual, oh, I recognize him. That's the guy I have to cheer. But unanimously, G Money's been supported by the fans in his quest to become Y Division champion, and he made it to the pinnacle. And he's coming up against Damo as, like I said, this is the match that needs to cement him as Y Division champion. If he doesn't win, I don't know what G Money's going to do. We don't know why he spent all that time winning the title, getting to that point where you win the title. You know, as I said, shenanigans afoot. We'll put that to the side. That's a whole other kettle of fries. But this is the match he needs to win. This is, it was all well and good getting there, getting the clause to be a title change, having a DQ and all that kind of stuff. He put the work in to get there. Now he needs to put in the work to keep it. And that's going to be the most interesting part of this match, because, you know, we've seen Joe Henry. He had the same kind of journey with Joe Coffey. He had to get desperate at times. Once he won the title, he made the pinnacle. He then started becoming possessed by this title. And there's a little bit of a curse with it as well, that it turned people into different people, different mindsets, and Gollum-esque in possession of that belt. And we've got to see if Gene Money is maybe, will he buck that trend? Will he be the guy that is the fighting champion, is the champion for the people? And Big Damo is the biggest threat possibly that Discovery Wrestling could have thrown in at him straight away. And with all that in mind, both these guys will have to look at the Disco Derby as well. Because there's no outright rule. I mean, I'm assuming it'll be the case because Disco Derby will likely be the main event, but there's no hard and fast rule that says that the winner of the Disco Derby can not cash in the same night. So if these guys have an absolute war, an absolute meat slapping barn burner, all the hyperbole that goes with it, there's nothing to say that the show will end with whoever wins the Disco Derby thinks they're a little bit fresh. We'll just go, you know what? Get the champion out here now. We're going to have the title match. We're going to do it. And if these guys have just absolutely leathered each other for 15 to 20 minutes, they're not going to be, they would have to have some sort of reserves somewhere to try and combat that. And that's another facet of this match. It makes it fascinating. This is, again, I'm talking about show stealers. I'm talking about the potential show stealers in the ticket holder matches. I'm talking about the underrated possibilities of the Women's Championship match. For those that like hard-hitting slaps and chops, there's your tag team match. This one is going to be a fantastic match, because both guys will be desperate to win, and they'll have to show that they have different tactics to do that. G-Money is relying on his Angel Lariat. Will he be able to topple Big Damo with it? That's the big question.
Oh, didn't see you there. TV's Omar Mohammed here. It's been a while, Discovery Wrestling. Walk with me. We all know that I was unsuccessful in the Disco Derby last year. However, I did move on to bigger and better things. And if that's what happens when I lose the Disco Derby, what happens when I win? I mean, let's look at the competition. Let's see who's really in the Disco Derby. The Aberdonian ace, Zach Dynamite.
Oh my god.
Wait, well, Lost Boy Aspen. Oh my god. Right, well, Caleb Valhalla. Okay, cut that. All I'm saying is life is going pretty sweet for the Sensation right now. But after I win the Disco Derby, it's going to get a whole lot more sensational.
And finally, it's the main event of the Disco Derby. The match, hence the title, is the Disco Derby match itself. So I was having a look through what we got of the entrance confirmed. And, you know, as I said, I always say I love a Rumble. I love these kind of matches. I love the kind of twist that's on this kind of match. It's a Rumble, final two have a one-on-one match, and then the winner gets a shot at a championship. Usually it's the Y Division Championship, but as it's proven, Jack Morris cashed in his opportunity very recently in Livingston for the Impact Wrestling Digital Media Championship against Joe Hendry. So it's no out rule that says it has to be for the Y Division Championship. So that leaves things a bit open. So we've got some tag team competitors in there. And we've got some ladies in there, but that's not to say they won't compete for the heavyweight title. So it leaves everything very much open and up for debate on what title the winner will go for if they decide to cash it in as soon as possible, the next show, or they want to hold on to it for 12 months. We don't know. And that's what makes it, again, interesting, fascinating. That's why it becomes a very it's a ticking time bomb. You're holding that. It's whether you decide to cash in and take advantage of it or what. We'll have a look, see who won though. And I think with the exception of 2019, I think Session Moth Martinez win, she cashed in on the women's title and won it. I think that would be, again, a speculation of my mind here. Andy Wilde won 2018. He cashed in, he didn't win. Jack Morris, 2022, cashed in, didn't win. So there's not a great track record for winners of the Disco Derby to win the title. So this could be the year that bucks the trend. So let's go through the entrants, and I can tell you how some of them qualified as well. Frank Gallo was the first to qualify. He defeated Ryan Richards in, I think it was Livingston. No, it wasn't. It was at Excellent Venture. Lost by Aspen, Caleb Valhalla. They entered, they got a call. Well, Aspen got a call while they were fighting because they're still looking to fight forever. Are Caleb a Lost Boy? Even though, weird call Lost Boy just as the first name. Even though the point of Excellent Adventure is they're supposed to form this amazing tag team and save Scottish wrestling. We still haven't got to that point where they finally go, right, we'll stop fighting. We're going to become a team, and they're going to take on Kings of the North. They're going to take on Kez Evans and BT Gunn. I'm still waiting for that point. I've got Will Cruz, Ian Skinner. Ian Skinner is, he put out a little video after Excellent Adventure, after he was Principal Skinner, about this new attitude of Ian Skinner. And we're going to see a lot of it, of this new attitude, this kind of, I don't know how to describe it in a way that I can put it onto YouTube for people to families to watch this particular show. But he's got this attitude, again, their chip on his shoulder, and this kind of thing going on when he's down like soft pro and what have you. So I think we might get a little bit more of that Ian Skinner now in Discovery Wrestling. It'll be very interesting because he's just one of those really talented individuals, and he knows he's a very talented boy and grasping a character and use it to the max and be very entertaining and articulate in promos and things like that. So I think if we see that Ian Skinner and Disco, that would be really interesting. But it's one of those things where if Ian Skinner has an idea, most of the time it'll smash it out of the park. But I'm still waiting for Austin Powers Pro Wrestling. I've got Judas Gray, who defeated Ronan King and Livingston. Rob Stowe won the Fatal 4-Way. As mentioned earlier on, with Dickie Divers, Jarek Novak, and Rob Mills. Tisha Moth Martina, former winner. Emerson Jane, former champion. Theo Doris, Deacon Matthews, Tommy Cartel, Daisy Jenkins, DCT, Alistair Karen, TV's Omar Muhammad, who we saw before I started talking about the Disco Derby. Zach Dynamite and Griffin. The most interesting one here is Luke King Sharp 2015, who seems to have escaped the time jump and vortex of Excellent Adventure, and he's still around in 2023. Is 2015's Luke King Sharp. Fix up Luke Sharp, skinny jeans, wearing Hawaiian shirt, adorned the weird Kanye West sunglasses thing as well. So I'll be interested to see how that kind of fares in 2023. Because he's the blood tourist elsewhere. He's like dungaree wearing, deathmatch loving, blood spurting Luke King Sharp elsewhere. And he's coming back. 2015 Luke King Sharp's appearing in this particular match. There's 19 names announced. Generally, there's 20 in the Disco Derby. So by the time this episode goes out on a Wednesday, it's probably already been announced who the final entrant is. But I hope it isn't. Because I want a surprise. I want a surprise to enter. I don't know who. Whether it's going to be whoever loses the Y Division Championship match. Whether it's Dickie Divers finding his way in. Whether it's Ronan King finding his way in. Or something like that. I think we need that surprise is always a great thing for our Rumbles. Because it's like a bone of contention for some people that I know. That are like, you don't need to announce everyone that's in a Rumble. Just announce some of the big names. But you don't need to announce everyone. It's more like it's a Schrodinger's Rumble. You don't know whether it's going to be full star-studded until you see it, kind of thing. Until you open the box and open the doors and you see who's in the match. But the lineup is stellar. It's a great mix of characters and wrestlers and styles. And as far as favorites go, I don't think there's anyone that's a standout. This guy is going to win. I think in previous years we've had, like 2018, I think it was kind of not obvious. I think Andy Wilde was the firm favorite to win, you know. 2019, probably Session Moth Martino was one of the bigger names in the match. Possibly was a favorite. 2022, Jack Morris, I think he was one of my top five favorites. So when I'm looking at this lineup, I don't know. And if I was throwing out five names off the top of my head now, and if I have time, I may do an article on the website. Do my five picks, but it's that difficult that I don't want to hedge my bets really with a 1-in-4 chance, because it's too difficult to call. I think you're looking at Ian Skinner as probably a top favorite with his new attitude. I can see him outlasting and using that chip on his shoulder to push his way through up into the front of the line. If he's not the winner, I would definitely say probably final two. We'll go with that. I'd say he's going to be the final two. And obviously, you know my bias is I'm going to say Lost by Aspen, Caleb Valhalla, Zach Dynamite. I think they would all be very worthy and worthy winners. And they've all got experience winning Rumbles as well. So it's not like it would be an absolute shock, but because they've got a little bit of winning experience in this kind of match. And I can see any of those trio challenging Big Demo or Gene Money in the future. Emerson Jane, I want to throw in there as well. That's five out, because I really want to mention Rob Stowe as well. I think Rob Stowe is a guy that clearly has some issues with Joe Hendry, and obviously the conclusion of Excellent Adventure had that going on. He's got Mr. Manival possibly in tow. It's very interesting that I want to throw him in there, so I've got five, six. at the moment. Ian Skinner, Aspen, Caleb, Dynamite, Stowe, Emerson Jade. They would be my kind of, I'd have to say they're your firm favorites. I can see guys like TV's Omar Muhammad doing really well, though. I can see Will Cruz having a big tear, maybe having a big beefy showdown with Aspen, with Caleb, with another showdown with Caleb. I can see Judas Gray doing something crazy. I can see Frank Gallo doing something crazy. Theodorus has been a guy that's been around Disco for a while. He's been at the main event spot with Joe Hendry. He could be a guy that could do fare very well in this particular match. This is probably the most open Disco Derby that's ever taken place. And this will be the fourth edition, the most open Disco Derby of all time. That's, I think I can safely say that with no doubts. Because, yeah, like I'm saying, it's just a case of, you can see, conceivably, of the 19 names I've listed, I've gone 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, yeah, 19. Of the 19 names I've listed, I could easily conceivably see at least 10 of those winning. That being, and even then, the other 9 could be in the final 2. It's that open for interpretation on who you think is going to win. I think it's really going to come down to that fight. Well, it's obviously going to come down to that final 2, but I think that the interesting thing will be that final 2 and where they've placed in the derby itself. If it's Ian Skinner at number 1, if it's Theodorus at number 20, and they end up clashing at the end, then of course Ian Skinner is going to have that intestinal fortitude to push on through and have to use that new attitude to get past Theodorus. It's Zach Dynamite, like I say, he's got the experience of winning Rumbles, and he's got it doing underhand thing. I mean, we have Bruiser Brad Evans and Ryan Riley have been announced for the Disco Derby. I don't know if they're going to be there. Will they have the foundation in the future to help him? Will we have Rob Stowe? I'm assuming Mr. Manival will be there, but will Joe Hendry be there to try and or distract Rob Stowe as revenge for Excellent Adventure? Will we see, just have a look through the names here, Tommy Cartel, FBWA's hardest wrestler in Fife. Could he have a backup? Could he have, because he's got Hunter Sampson in FPWA. Could he be there? I've got a DCT. We've seen what he's been doing in ICW at the moment. Could he have Adam King? Because I know Marcus is injured. Could he have one of the KOE about? Because part of his version of Polo Promotions. Luke King Sharp, 2015. Who was his pals in 2015? I mean, I'm not saying we're going to see Donnie T. But there's this possibilities of factions and people and outside forces that could help this match. Griffin has already put out a video. He's still kind of feeling the effects of Excellent Adventure, and he's still a bit flying Ryan, and he told Athena to stay home. And will that be a factor? Will him not having that protection of Athena help or hinder him in this match? That's the best thing about this match. It is so open to interpretation. You don't know who could win. There's no clear-cut favourite for this match. And that's what makes it the most unpredictable Disco Derby in the history of this match. It's going to be a wild one.
2 hours later.
I've talked about a new attitude for a long time. And I've not really acted on it yet. Until now. I'm undeclaring myself from the Disco Derby. Why? Because I don't deserve to be cheated once again. I got no redemption for being cheated out of the last Disco Derby. Jack Morris got to fly away to Japan and receive his flowers. I'm still awaiting my flowers for the work I did at Discovery Wrestling. And to be cheated out of another opportunity is just, it's not on me. I do have my eyes on one person though, Judas. I want to see you do your best, because in my eyes, you still need to earn a match against me. For me, surviving 19 people does not equal going to war with one person. I'll find a much more interesting way to get my championship opportunity than the Disco Derby.
So, You just heard that video there, of Ian Skinner undeclaring himself from the Disco Derby, which made me say he was one of the favorites. Made me look like a right willy, I'll be honest. It also actually makes my Fave Five now a Fave Five, which thank you, Ian, for that. So he's undeclared himself. He doesn't want to be in it. He wants to earn his way into a championship opportunity. He doesn't want to do it through the Disco Derby. He's going to find another way into the championship picture. And I heartily believe he will do. I think he's one of those guys where the companies aren't, possibly on the side of the border, aren't taking full advantage of what Ian Skinner can do and what he can provide, not only as a wrestler, but also as an entertainer and as a social media savvy wrestler. And yeah, he's gonna do well. I think 2023 might be, well, we've only got half a year left, but might be the year of Skinner into 2024. Like I said, I would have loved to see G Money or Big Demo against Ian Skinner, but one day. The year is not done, and his journey is not, he hasn't finished the story quite yet. So that leaves it 18 people being announced for the Disco Derby. That's 2 open spots. I'm going to hazard a guess because I didn't see him listed. Andy Roberts possibly will be in there. So I don't know who the last guy's going to be. Will it be Johnny Lyons? Will it be Molly Spartan? Will it be Randy Valentine? Will it be Retro Randy? Who knows? This is the beauty of the Disco Derby and the Rumble, when not all the competitors are announced. We get a little bit of surprises in there as well. Could be Anthina. She could be there if she's been cast aside by Flying Ryan Griffin for the moment, for the time being. She could appear. And I still want Anthina versus Kayla Valhalla. Give me that match somewhere. Livingston, put it in one of the Livingston shows. Put it somewhere. I want to see that match. But yeah, that's hopefully all the changes to the card. Let's go to the last, like, little minute where I was all really chuffed myself. I did a full review on the Monday, a full preview on the Monday, and ignore my glumness at doing wee changes. I mean, I don't have to do changes, but I think for posterity purposes, if I'm going to put this out, then it should be as up to date as possible with the match card, right? Right? Cool. And that's it. We've ran through the whole card for Disco Derby taking place on July 1st at the Pleasant Sports Complex in Edinburgh. If you haven't got your ticket, go get your ticket. Go to this show. This is going to be amazing. I can't wait for it to go on demand or go to YouTube. I want to see this show as soon as I possibly can. Like I said, unfortunately, I cannot go to the show, but I want people to go so they can pack out the complex, pack out the venue, and we can go see some damn good wrestling, create some noise and atmosphere. To cheer on your favourites and to boo your not so favourites. So full match lineup. We've got Ronan King, Conor Malloy, and we've got Double D's versus Rob Mills and Yarick Novak of the Sea Bears as your VIP ticket holder matches. Two of the matches. Discovery Wrestling Women's Championships online. Casey defends against Nina Samuels. In a tag team championship match, Kings of the North defend against Kez Evans and BT Gunn. In a Y Division Championship match, in an open challenge answered by Big Demo, he takes on Gene Money, the Y Division champion. And the main event, I assume, will be the Disco Derby, with 19 entrants confirmed, including former winners Session Moth Martina, and along with former champions like Emerson Jane in this particular match. It's going to be a wild one. It's going to be an incredible night or afternoon of wrestling. Just go. It's all about the disco. It's all about the wrestling. Go and enjoy it. I have been your host, Billy. This has been All About the Disco. Have a good one, and I can't wait to see what the results of the show are.